New World is a fantasy MMORPG set in an alternate reality very similar to the colonial era. Players are called to explore the island of Aeternum, a newly discovered land in the middle of the Atlantic, modeled after British America. The game has been anticipated for quite a while, but has unfortunately suffered major setbacks in its release schedule, setbacks that had as a result the delay of its official release twice. First in May this year and later in August. New World is now planned for a release sometime in spring of 2021 with a new alpha and beta phase taking place the months before. The developers, however, had decided to open the game to backers and fans now on August 25th and until September 4th, while at the same time lifting the NDA and allowing us to discuss its features. Hello everybody, I am Squid of Love and this is a first look at the New World preview. New World is being developed by Amazon Game Studios and is aspiring to become the flagship title for this developer, the game that will establish the studio as a good, successful developer and allow Amazon to get a strong foothold in the gaming industry. Knowing the expectations and goals of New World makes it easy to understand the two delays and the fact that this game will not be released unless the developers are 100% satisfied with the outcome. New World started its journey as a semi-hardcore PvP experience where players could lose everything equipped if they went too far. In that PvP environment, PvE was just a means to an end. A way to earn experience, items and money so you can have more fun PvPing all day. The reception from the audience was not as good as expected and quickly the developers decided to switch the focus of the game from PvP to PvE in order to avoid the inevitable failure of New World. This decision gave to the title a breath of fresh air and skyrocketed its popularity. So in the end it was a wise move, but not enough as we can see and experience in the preview today. The main problem was that while the focus of the game had shifted from PvP to PvE, the gameplay content remained exactly the same. The PvE of New World that was just a means to an end was crowned suddenly as the king of gameplay, the aspect of the game responsible for success. And no matter how good the gameplay is, and believe me, it is really good, that is not enough. The realization of this important detail eventually led to the second delay of New World, which probably is now heading for a massive revamp, and maybe when it will be released next year, it will have very few in common with the current preview. Either way, let's focus on the preview available to us, starting with the gameplay. The core feature of New World is its great combat system. One of the best experiences I have seen in a similar MMORPG so far, and the main reason to keep playing. Combat can be brutal, jumping ahead, attacking your enemies with force to take them fast down, but can also be smart and tactical. Your playstyle depends a lot on the weapons you are using. A massive hammer for pure offense, sword and shield for more defense, or bow, musket and staves for ranged gameplay. At the moment there are only a few weapons available in the game, but logically more will be added by the time of its release. Every weapon has its own unique skill trees with active and passive skills you can unlock and combine together in order to create your own personal build for PvE or PvP gameplay. And players can use and unlock every weapon and skill in the game. PvP is still very important for the world of New World, but players can now choose whether they want to participate or not. The PvP aspect of the game is based on the struggle between the three factions, Marauders, Covenant and Syndicate. The factions always fight each other for control over territories and power. After a certain level, players can choose to join a faction and assist in the fight. The main PvP event of the game at the moment is 50 vs 50 siege events that take place once a faction has amassed enough influence to challenge the owner of a territory. The battle takes place in an instanced area and no other players than the one selected for the fight can interfere. Alternatively, players can choose to opt in for PvP while adventuring in the world and fight other players that have also opted in for PvP. If you do not want to PvP and do not opt in for PvP, nobody can attack you. A feature I find great personally because it eliminates Griffin. The PvP sieges are basically the PvP endgame of New World. But what about PvE? There are a lot more options here. Settlements in territory offer several quests, missions, and town projects to complete, helping you with experience and making money. A player can choose to accept and complete the main quest of the game or one of the countless missions available to him to proceed, or he simply can go out and start farming specific NPC enemies for experience, money, and loot. The world outside the cities is vibrant and full of danger, with four main types of hostile NPC factions: the Corrupted, the Ancient, the Lost, and the Angry Earth. Each one of these enemies have their own unique appearance, behavior, and lore to discover. Speaking of lore, there are plenty of info you can discover about the world of Aeternum, and this is another cool little aspect of the game. NPC enemies have their own attack patterns, and they can even dodge your attacks, making your life harder, but combat challenging and interesting. The problem with PvE lies mostly on missions and the quest design, which is rather archaic for a 2020 MMORPG title. Most quests ask you to go to a certain area to kill an X number of enemies or gather X number of items and then return, creating an endless back and forth boring session. If you add to this the lack of mounts in the game, we can very well understand why New World had to be delayed again. Regarding mounts, they don't exist, and developers never planned to have them in game at first. The map is indeed small and you can travel from one area to another relatively fast on foot, but walking everywhere becomes old fast and creates a very bad experience. Hopefully we will see mounts being added to the game before its official release. The endgame for PvE includes PvE sieges, where corrupted NPC attack a territory, and special boss-like fights, where players are fighting hard enemies called the Ancient. Both types of gameplay are instanced. There are no dungeons or raids planned for the game yet, but will probably come later. Gathering and crafting is also very important for the game and its economy. I dare say that New World is going to be an amazing game for you if you are into crafting. Players can make anything from weapons and armor to food and potions to use for themselves or sell for profit. Player housing exists as well. You can buy up to 3 houses, decorate them with furniture and trophies you craft, find, or buy, and also use them as port points to travel fast. You can teleport from one settlement to another using Azoth, teleport to your house, or teleport to the inn of a settlement as a means of fast travel. This makes the lack of mounts somewhat less annoying, to be honest. Finally, Azoth is a very important part of the game, used in teleportation, crafting, and even unlocking faction tiers to buy unique items. It can drop randomly from most NPC enemies, but you can also farm it by closing corrupted breaches around the map. Overall, New World is an amazing combat MMORPG with immense potential, but with a few problematic details holding it back at the moment. Thankfully, the time until its new release is enough to fix all the issues and emerge as one of the best MMOs in the market. Thank you very much for joining me. If you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on bell notifications. I am Squid of Love, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.